Hello, everyone. Welcome. Thank you for watching. My name is Pat Cupo. I'm a musician, I'm a producer, and I'm super, super excited to introduce you to the brand new operators feature in Bitwig Studio. These are going to take your note sequence and audio events to a brand new time and space that you probably wouldn't have thought possible. So I can't wait to show you. Let's check it out. Operators change how and when notes are triggered, and there are four operator modes. First up is chance. Chance makes each note more or less likely. Then there's repeats. Repeats allow each event to re-trigger at a set rate or just divide the note length into any number of pieces. Yes, you can ramp the timing of these and the velocities for note repeats. And a slice to repeats option is available to print out the individual events. Next up is occurrence. Occurrence sets conditions for each event, like, is this the first loop of the clip or not? Did the previous event play or was it silent? Or is the performance control fill button turned on? And finally, there's recurrence. Recurrence thinks of each event as its own looping timeline. So pick a cycle length, say every four loops of the clip, and then check off whether the event plays on each of those four passes. And now that we know about the operator modes, let's see them in action. All right, in this project, I have four main tracks, all utilizing operators in a variety of ways. Here's a quick listen and watch for the fill button up top, which you can find under play and playback. So diving in, let's start with the drums. First thing to notice is the crash on beat one. You probably don't want that sounding at the beginning of every single bar, so try using the recurrence mode to determine when it'll actually play. For example, I have it set up to come in every 8 measures. Next, take a look at the dice icons on the note heads themselves. Those tell you how likely the notes will play on each loop of the clip. And this beat, I liked how the open hi-hat will sometimes ring out because the closed hi-hat doesn't play due to its chance percentage. Actually, my favorite thing to do is combine the chance and recurrence modes. Definitely experiment with stacking logic, so to speak. And then finally, there's this awesome fill button. As you can see, there's a bunch of longer notes up top. Look closely and there's a plus sign on them indicating that these notes will play when fill mode is on. In this example, I have those notes going through an arpeggiator when fill is on, and then there are notes being turned off. So fill mode can add some small fills, but it can actually reveal an entirely new idea. All right, let's take a listen to this beat. Next up, let's look at the lead and keys parts together. So if I'm being honest, something I always do when I write a clip is think, what do I do next? I don't know. Well, using the operators modes, I'm starting to think, how can I take what I've already written and spread it out even further? In this example, I have the keys playing a 4-bar clip but arranged over 4 loops of it. So this 4-bar idea actually turned into a 16-bar idea, and I absolutely love having that ability now. And while the keys are doing their thing, the lead is using a combination of repeats and recurrence, which contributes to its moody vibe. In addition to that, when I press the 0 key on my keyboard, I activate lots of effects in the fill mode up above. That's activating some new notes in the keys track while the lead part goes down an octave. Now let's hear it all put together. Finally, the bass part. This is actually made from a bounce of VST, so this means yes, the operator modes also work with audio events, which just makes me happy. Something to definitely try out is upping the repeats amount to a high value and getting pitches out of those fast repeats. I haven't taken it that far yet, but you could probably make some interesting sounding melodies out of repeats alone. Try it, have some fun. Let's take a listen. To take things a huge step further, there is another operator's feature for you called expand. Similar to bouncing, expand lets you take what chance, repeats, occurrence, and recurrence are doing over many cycles of your clips and expand them into one clip. Let's try this out. I'll right-click on the drums clip, select expand, and this menu is asking how many repeats of this one measure loop I'd like, and if I like to keep the chance percentages that I programmed, which can be a lot of fun. I think I'd like 8 repeats, and yes, I'll definitely preserve chances. I'll press OK, and let's see what we get. So as you can see, the variety made possible by the operators is now visible, and we've maintained the spontaneity by preserving the chance percentages. Cool, let's try this out on the keys track now. I'll right-click, select expand, and this time I'll go for 4 repeats and opt out to preserve any chance settings. So there you have it, the brand new operators in Bitwig Studio. I for one know that I'll be using them in pretty much everything I do now, and I'm really looking forward to see what you guys do with it, the Bitwig community. So take these, have fun, experiment, see what kind of crazy combinations of operators you can come up with. Take care, and I'll see you next time.